In this video, we are going to explore some functions of the 2D Scanner Editor app. First of all, we need to download the software from the main page 2dscanner.com, Support, Downloads. Find and click 2D Scanner Editor button and the file will download. Installation is not required. It is a portable version. Click and run it. Bypass the security warning. Click More Info and run anyway. Here we go. This is the main screen. The initial screen displays basic instructions. Spend a few minutes to read this. It explains how to navigate and use the mouse efficiently. Let's open a file now. This is a scanned room. Editor provides us the tools to check many aspects of our scan. First of all, we can see all the points scanned. At this side, we have a window and strange behavior because of the glass. While in the opposite side, this looks like a door. Now let's check the signal quality of the measurements. This section has small circles. This means good signal. While at this side, the circles are larger. This does not mean we have a poor scan. In some cases, we may avoid poor scans or explain strange behavior by checking the signal. This is not a case like this. This one is a really good scan. Now let's see the powerful tool of trace lines. Lines and dimensions are automatically generated. These points here are of no interest and I will delete them. Draw a rectangle with right key down and press delete. Let's delete some more points. Double middle click fits to screen the whole drawing. Trace lines again to get the new lines. In this line, the maximum deviation is only 3.4 millimeters. The point that has the maximum distance from the theoretical line is next to the number. This angle is 90.33 degrees. Let's take a closer look. This point here affects the line. I will delete these 3 points and trace lines again. Now we have a better precision angle, 90.88 degrees. Let's open another file. This is a nice clean scan. Trace lines at once. This area here should have more points. Now we cannot trust this 97.27 angle. A line needs at least 3 points so that it can be trusted. Let's use the line to X-axis button to rotate the drawing. Left click at the desired line and the drawing will rotate accordingly. Let's see another tool now. First, I will arrange windows side by side. And I will click Tools menu. Generate thumbnails. Choose a file in the folder of interest. It doesn't matter which one. The program will use only the file's path. And as you can see, image thumbnails are created. The application generates thumbnails for all 2D scanner files. Now you can easily navigate in your scans. Drag and drop it in the editor and it will be opened. Convert multiple files to DXF in the Tools menu works the same way with the thumbnails. Again, pick up any file. The application will use only the file's path. And our DXF files are ready. Default settings are used for this conversion to DXF. If a cleaner DXF is needed, we can export any file individually. Let's delete some points just for the tutorial. And click Export Visible to DXF in File menu. Our DXF is ready. Here it is. The red polyline is the traced lines layer. The point cloud is simplified to lines. And this is the corrected points layer. As you can see, there is one more layer. Raw points. We will explain the difference using another example. Click Raw Values checkbox and a blue line appears identical with the corrected point lines. If we zoom in a lot, a small difference between these lines will come up. In this example, it is less than 0.5 millimeters. If we open the MSR file, we can see the roll value of the device during the scan. These numbers indicate the roll alignment of 2D scanner during the scan. For the tutorial, I will change this number to 9 and reopen the file. Here is the first point. As you can see, there is a significant difference between the corrected and raw value. Let's change a few more roll angles to 9 and see what happens. Now we have major displacement values. In conclusion, if 2dscanner is misplaced and has a roll angle of even 5 degrees, both Smart App and Editor correct the measurements. The raw values are the original value scanned. Corrected with roll are the calibrated values. In vertical scans, you will need the raw values. If roll bigger than 10 degrees is detected, then automatically this adjustment is bypassed. No need to worry which one to use. These details are explained for special applications where roll is below 10 degrees and yet we need the raw values. That's all. The editor is simple and efficient. Happy scanning!